Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am going to show you how to make this blueberry salsa. Now, I know blueberry salsa sounds really crazy, but let me just tell you, I think this is the best salsa that I have ever made in my entire life. It is so good. The flavors are just busting out of this dish. It's so good, I impressed myself. All right, y'all, if you want to see how I make it, stay tuned. So we're gonna start with something a little different. I have yellow and red heirloom tomatoes, and they're just two small ones cut up. So I'm gonna add those first to the bowl. They're so juicy. I love heirloom tomatoes. Heirloom. And next we are going to add 2 cups of blueberries. And I just wasn't sure if blueberries was gonna be a hit for this, but let me just tell y'all, don't be afraid to put blueberries in salsa. Also, you can use strawberries if you don't like blueberries. But next we're gonna add ripe avocado. That's just one avocado chopped. You can chop the pieces smaller if you would like. And then next we're gonna add some fresh cilantro. And I think this probably made the dish come together. The cilantro was just so fresh. I think that made a big difference. I added about 1/2 cup chopped. Also, as usual, I will put a link below in the description box with the ingredients for this recipe. This is a juice of 1 lime. I guess you can use lemon, but I think lime works best in this recipe. Then we have about 1/2 teaspoon of cumin. You can either use cumin or coriander. I happen to like cumin better because it has a more of a smoky taste. And then this is just a dash of black ground pepper. You can put it in or leave it out if you would like to, but I think it adds a little bit of a depth of flavor. Next is some pink Himalayan salt. Honestly, I don't know if this dish had needed salt. I just added it before I tasted it, so it wasn't too salty. But last but not least of the spices is a little bit of chipotle seasoning. You can use any type of pepper seasoning you would like, or you could leave it out if you don't like spicy, although that little bit of chipotle did not make this dish spicy at all. And the only thing I did after that is stir everything together so that all the flavors could meld together. And let me tell you, the flavors married well. And that was even before it sat. Sometimes when you make salsa, it tastes better the longer you let it sit. But this didn't even have to sit to taste good. So I can't even imagine what it's gonna taste like in a few hours when I eat it with my dinner. There you have it, blueberry salsa. Who knew? This video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and please don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, y'all, take care.